Right here we have motherboard from a MacBook Pro 13-inch 2011, model number 820-2936. So the issue with this board is that it doesn't power on, and in fact we don't even get a green light on the MagSafe. So we have free plugging the MagSafe. As you can see, no green light at all. So there are a couple of checks we can do in this situation with the multimeter. So first one is to make sure we indeed get some voltage on the input of the board, so right on the MagSafe connector. So as you can see, we get 16.7 volts, which is perfectly fine. And then we can start going down the path of power rails. So if we are missing the green light, the power rail, the most important right now is the PP3U42 underscore G3H. So if we switch to the board view right here, we are going to look for PP3U42. And it's supposed to show up on top of here, for example. We are going to measure the voltage right there. So it's on this large capacitor. And we get 3.47 volts, which should be fine. Just a bit above what we expect. And the next step, we want to check PPBus G3H. PPBus G3H is not necessarily needed for the green light, but it can tell us if the SMC is running. So when PPBus G3H is at 12.6 volts, SMC is running fine, so it should show a green light, and if it's at 12.2 volts, it means the SMC hasn't started, so green light will not come up. So on the board view, G3H can be measured right here, for example. So we are right here. And we get 0.1 volts, which is no good at all. PPBus G3H has a problem, so we can go from there just to see what the issue is with PPBus G3H. So first thing, we check if we have a short to ground. And we have some sort of short to ground because PPBus G3H is supposed to be at least several kilohms, and here we have only somewhere around 800 ohms, so this is too low. And if we swap over the board, what's interesting is what's happening right there. So right here, you can see a couple of things. So you won't really see with this smartphone camera, but if we take a closer look, you can see that the IC has been revoked before. It's not the factory solder joints. And another thing is that we have some blue right there that is burned. So someone was here before and gives us a nice hint, because this IC that we are looking at, it's this one, U7000, which is the charger IC. So if we take a look on the schematics, U7000, it's this guy, and this guy, the ISL6259, is responsible for creating the PWSG3H. And another interesting thing is that with the charger plugged in, it's heating up quite a lot. And I'm burning my finger on there. So first thing we are gonna do is replace this chip with one from the donor board, and at the same time we're gonna replace the MOSFETs, so Q7030 and Q7035, because if the high side MOSFET right here gets shorted, it can kill the controller, and if the controller dies, it can kill the MOSFET. So it's always a good idea to replace both at the same time, and while we are there, we will replace Q7035 as well. So we're gonna be taking it from this board. This board is 2879, the model from the year before. But it doesn't matter because it's using the same ISL6259. The only thing is that it's placed a bit differently, and we are gonna have to take a look at the MOSFETs as well to make sure they are compatible. Okay, here we are on the 2879. I'm gonna look for U7000, which is right here. They are not the same package. Let's see. Okay, so on the 2879, the MOSFETs are right here. Those two. And on the 2936, they are right there. And obviously the package doesn't match, so you can't swap the MOSFETs right now. So let's place a bet if it's only the charger IC that bad, and replace only this one for now, and hope it doesn't get killed again by the MOSFETs in the airboard. So we are gonna remove this chip, take this one here, and put it right there. So we are gonna tin the pad with some fresh native solder. We are gonna need some more flux. Okay. And just remove some solder from the center pad. So now that's done, I'm gonna put some more flux. Take the IC from the other board and put it right there. And we are just gonna confirm something. I'm gonna confirm the orientation that it will have. So if we are looking the 2936 board, sorry, 2879 board, pin 1 is right there, and the 2936, pin 1 is right there. So let's rotate it. So we have pin 1 on top right, indicated by these small dots right there. Okay, let me quickly check if it looks soldered properly. should be fine. Let's do a quick check that the MOSFETs aren't shorted. So right now we are looking at this MOSFET and this one. We want to check if they are shorted drain to source and drain to gate or source to gate. Same for this one, drain to source, source to gate, and so on. Okay. So let's check this one. One mega ohm, so that's fine. Into gate, so 5 to 2 ohms, and this mega ohm, 5 kilos. So this one is fine. 32 kilos. Gate, 1 mega ohm. Okay, so they are not shorted. So they look like they are fine. And we're going to quickly check if the resistance to run on 15V G3H changed. And now you can see that it's more like it. 30 kilo ohms. We learn a little bit, but this is perfectly fine. So I'm gonna plug it in, just check if it's cooled down enough. It's still warm, but that's fine. So if we check TP+G3H, put the multimeter in view. No, 12.6 volts, meaning we have solved the issue on the TP+G3H and that the SMC is running properly. So green light might be just a bad contact. Yeah, see, green light. And do we have V-core maybe? Okay, so we have V-core, we have 1.2 volts on V-core. I don't have RAM plugged in, so it's not gonna post. If I plug in some RAM, we should see the board, the CPU record, sorry, going down to 0.8 volts, 0.8 or 0.9 volts somewhere around there. So let's do that. So right now it's cycling apparently, but